Hi everyone, I'm Ian Atkinson with NASA Spaceflight. Welcome to another Boca Chica update video. As always, all of the following photos and videos were captured by Mary at Boca Chica Gal on Twitter, an NSF team member and Boca Chica resident. Thanks, Mary. This week, we saw SpaceX conduct some of the last tests on Starship SN9 ahead of its upcoming flight. With SN9, SpaceX hopes to replicate the flight of SN8, except this time stick the landing. Elon Musk stated on Twitter that SpaceX is now using helium to pressurize the methane header tank, a small spherical tank that holds fuel for landing. The header tank was the culprit behind SN8's failed landing, when it lost pressure during flight, starving the engines of fuel. On Wednesday, SN9 performed its first static fire. It seemed shorter than usual, only around 2 seconds long. SpaceX then tried to repeat the test twice, but it was aborted both times. As of recording, the next available window for the static fire would be Monday, January 11th. We could then see SN9's 12.5 kilometer flight as early as Tuesday, January 12th. Fingers crossed. Crews also finished the cleanup of debris from Starship SN8, left over from its failed landing just over a month ago. The final segments were cut apart and hauled away on Tuesday, clearing the landing pad for SN9's upcoming flight. The so-called crater on the pad was also repaired, with fresh concrete being poured on Monday. Just next door, work on the orbital launch site progressed at a quick pace. Groundwork continued as crews laid electrical conduits for the future launch facility. The giant crane, nicknamed Tankzilla, was moved away from the launch site on Friday to protect it should SN9 fail during its flight. The crane is now stored next to the Appleton Crane Building, just across the street from the solar farm. Tankzilla was previously used to stack SN8's nose cone on the launch pad, and to move SN9 onto Pad B. Finally, refurbishment work at suborbital Pad A is still underway, as crews worked on tearing up old concrete near the base of the pad. These repairs may be related to the damage that Pad A endured during the SN8 test campaign, where chunks of the pad were blown away during engine testing. At the build site, Starship SN10 remains in the high bay for final processing. Last week, we saw its nose cone being stacked on the tank section inside the high bay. Now, SN10 is only missing its two aft flaps, which could be installed either at the build site or on the launch pad. This week, we also had to say goodbye to an old friend. Disassembly of Starship SN6, the second full-scale prototype to perform a 150-meter hop, began on Wednesday. Crews first removed its 22-ton mass simulator, followed by its Tesla battery pack. By Saturday, most of the vehicle had been disassembled. Its common dome, topped with the methane header tank, was spotted in the scrapyard. Farewell, SN6, and thank you. And just next to SN6, disassembly of Starship Mark 1 continued. A few weeks ago, we saw the nose cone being removed from the barrel section. Now, the barrel section has been cut in half and removed from the assembly stand, where it was kept for over a year. The nose cone itself was also cut in half on Saturday. The top half of the barrel has been moved to the scrapyard, so the future doesn't seem too bright for Starship Mark 1. Work is also continuing on a new test tank to trial new build methods for the Starship vehicle. The tank will be made of 3mm wide stainless steel, like this test article, rather than the 4mm steel used up until now. Although it may seem like only a minor change, this may lead to a mass reduction of around 10 to 20 tons across the entire Starship vehicle. That means that Starship can put an extra 10 to 20 tons of payload into orbit, or send it to the Moon and Mars. The tank's forward, or top dome, was sleeved with a single ring on Tuesday. Its aft dome was spotted last Sunday. These two sections should be joined soon ahead of testing at the launch site. The new tank's test campaign would likely mirror that of SN7.1, pressurizing the tank with liquid nitrogen until it bursts. Speaking of new hardware, Starship SN15 began stacking in the midbay this week. Yes, SN15. It seems like SN12 to 14 won't be built after all, which some have been speculating over the past few weeks. Last week, what we assumed to be a section of SN12 was moved into the midbay. However, that turned out to actually be part of SN15, as SN15's common dome section was then moved into the midbay and stacked on top of it. Starship SN15 will feature several major changes according to Elon. While the specific changes are not known, they may include a simplified nose cone and refined landing legs. Next to SN15, Starship SN11 is nearing the end of its assembly. The tank section is fully assembled in the midbay, but work on the nose cone is off to a bumpy start. On Tuesday, the nose cone was rolled back inside of tent number 3, and the four-ring barrel section was rolled out behind it. Then, on Wednesday, the header tank portion was cut off the nose cone. It's unclear if they will attach a new one on top or scrap the nose cone altogether. Back near the midbay, sections of future starships were spotted, with ring stacks for SN15, 16, and 17 spotted on Tuesday. And last but not least, Raptor SN45 was delivered to the production site on Thursday, sporting a moss green finish. It's not currently known what vehicle Raptor SN45 will end up on. And that's it for this week. Thanks for watching, and as always, we welcome any feedback about the video in the comments below. If you'd like to support the channel, consider becoming a member. Membership comes with perks like access to the members-only Discord channel, as well as preview video clips early in the day. You can also visit our store with a whole range of t-shirts, posters, and more. We'll see y'all next week.